So you decided to start an online business and you realized one thing, you're gonna need an email list, and that email list is going to need a nurture sequence. As a newbie content creator, business owner, you're probably thinking like, what the heck do I even put in a nurture sequence? I have nothing to sell and I have a whole pile of 2 pieces of content to my name. Well, I see you, I hear you, damn, I am you. So in this video, I'm going to give you a behind the scenes look at my newbie friendly nurture sequence and break down the purpose and content behind each of the emails I have in my sequence. Be sure to stick around to the end because I'm actually going to show you inside of my Flodesk account at exactly how I've set up the automated workflow for my nurture sequence. Hey lovelies, welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, I am Teri-Ann, website designer, side hustler, and that tech friend with all of the tips, tricks, and advice to help you build your business, keep it consistent, and start living that entrepreneurial life you've always wanted. All right, now that we've got that out of the way, let's get into the video. So before you jump in and start writing your nurture sequence, you want to get really clear on what is the purpose and goal of that nurture sequence. Obviously, the main purpose of a nurture sequence is to welcome your new subscribers and give them a little insight into who you are, what you do, how you can help them. But what is in it for you? What are you going to get out of the nurture sequence? How is this nurture sequence going to help you help them? The 2 main focuses I've included in my own nurture sequence, which you'll see throughout this entire video, is market research and building connections. When you're just getting started with a new online business or becoming a content creator, you might have an idea of who your ideal client is. You've probably done some research, competitive analysis, things like that, that you know that you're supposed to do. But let's be honest, when you're just getting started, a lot of that comes down to guesswork. You're guessing what your ideal audience is struggling with. You're guessing what their pain points are. That's why I've used my nurture sequence as a way to do market research, to ask those questions, to find out what their struggles are, find out where they're at in their journey, and just get to know them a bit more so that you can then take that information and use it to help them and obviously build your business. The second thing is building a connection. I heard Gary Vee refer to this method as the Taylor Swift method, which as a secret, not so secret Swiftie, I kind of love this. But the concept is do the unscalable. Do the unscalable. As a new content creator, online business owner, you have the opportunity to build those direct one-on-one connections with your audience while your audience is still small. And it's going to be those one-on-one connections that see you through, that send you referrals, that bring more people into your network. That is what's really gonna build your business when you first get started. So do the unscalable by building those one-on-one connections with your subscribers through your email. Email one is the opt-in delivery, and it has to do one simple thing, which is to deliver whatever it is your subscriber signed up to receive. This is usually gonna be a freebie, a lead magnet, some kind of resource that you've said that you would give them if they give you their email. So what I've included in my opt-in email is firstly, I've delivered what I said I would give them, which is a freebie of some kind. I'm also asking them a question that's going to help me with my market research. And that question is around who it is that's actually signing up for my email list. And the third thing is hinting at what they can expect over the coming days. When you're sending someone through a nurture sequence workflow, it can feel a little bit overwhelming because you are sending them email every single day. Even if it's only for 4 days, it can seem like a lot. So you want to let them know that, hey, this is what's going to happen over the next few days, but I'm just welcoming you. This isn't forever. So give them a little insight into what they can expect over the coming days, you know, just to give them a heads up. Email 2 is all about gratitude and expectations. Now, this is where the real nurturing begins. I wanted to make it very, very clear in this email just how grateful and thankful I am to my new subscribers that they've taken the time to engage with my content and trusted me enough to join my email list. As a beginner content creator, it's pretty awesome when somebody subscribes to your email list. So let them know, roll out the red carpet, light a couple of sparklers. The second thing is a quick introduction. And I say quick introduction because in email 3, which we'll get to in a second, we're going to dive into who you are and your brand story a little bit more. So for now, just give them a quick introduction as to who you are, what you do, how you help. In mine, I've just put bullet points. I've kept it very, very simple. Then you want to outline the expectations. So again, people like to know what they're in for. So we've already let them know, hey, you're in the nurture sequence. This is what to expect. In this email, I'm letting them know that, hey, you're now on my email list. I send out weekly emails. Here's what to expect from those weekly emails. Let them know in advance what to expect. So when it hits their inbox, they're ready for it and they don't automatically hit that unsubscribe. The very, very last thing again is we're working on our market research here. So in this one, I've included a question around where they're at in their journey. I'm asking them, hey, where are you at? Have you started your business? Have you launched it? Are you building a side hustle? What are you doing? Tell me more. And I'm asking them to respond directly to that email so that I can start building that one-on-one connection. Remember, market research, building connections. So the third email is about your brand story and struggles. Here's where you're going to dive a little bit deeper into one of the core stories within your brand and the struggles within that story that's going to help you build a connection with your subscriber. So what pain points does your subscribers have that you can relate to? What advice and help can you offer them? Now remember, our key call to action throughout this entire series is based around getting our subscribers to respond to our emails. Let's wrap up what you want to include within this so that you know that your subscribers are going to get something out of it. You want to share a core piece of your brand story. Spotlight your difference. What sets you apart from others in your industry or your niche? Another thing you want to do is you want to start sprinkling in components of your brand to further build relatability. And when I talk about brand components, I mean, what parts of you personally have you chosen to include as part of your brand? For example, within my stories, I've made mention that I love margaritas, that I love Lego, that I'm obsessed with Harry Potter. I've made mention of Taylor Swift. When you're building a personal brand, you want to be able to connect to them on a level that's outside of what you offer and how you can help them. What else can you be relatable with? And again, ask them a question that helps you with your market research. Ask them a question about their business. Dive more into what it is they want to achieve. What's their five-year goal? What it is that they want to achieve? What would be a successful outcome for their business? Then finally, the very last thing you want to do here is you want to hint at a little gift that you're going to give them in the next and final email. The reason you want to do that is because you want to keep them engaged. They've already received 2-3 emails from you at this point. They might start to feel a little bit overwhelmed. So by saying, hey, you've made it this far. Awesome. Thank you so much for that. Because of that, in tomorrow's email, I'm going to give you a little something, you know? And the very last email is giving them the little gift and getting social. So as we round out the nurture sequence, we want to give them a little something for kind of coming along this journey with you. This is a little subscriber only gift. It does not have to be anything major. It can be a check sheet, just a cheat sheet, a checklist, a workbook, anything that you think could help them. You could even just record a video and give them a subscriber only training of some kind, anything. You could do anything that is going to be something special only for your subscribers. You also want to let them know that this is now the end of the nurture sequence and direct them to follow you wherever it is that you were the most active. You don't want to send them to a Facebook page where the last thing you posted was a meme from 2017. That's not going to do you any favors. And what I would recommend is send them somewhere where you can continue to build a connection and a community with them. For instance, I've personally chosen to create a Discord community. That might seem a little out there, but in terms of who my audience is and what it is that I teach, Discord is a really good fit for that. Also, I'm not a fan of Facebook groups. I find them to be really messy and hard to control. So having a Discord group is very organized and I really like the layout of it. So to round that up, you want to give them a little gift and you want to send them somewhere where you can continue to build that connection with them. Okay, some really quick pointers before we jump into showing you through my workflow. You really want to focus on building connections, building a community, finding who those subscribers are who are going to stick with you for the long run. And make sure that you are responding to anyone that responds to these call to action questions that you are asking. There's only benefits that can come from you taking the time out of your day to respond to your subscribers. And if you are only getting 1-2 emails a day, a handful of comments from subscribers, you have absolutely zero reasons not to respond to them. Bit of tough love there. And remember to write how you speak. I took so much time rewriting my nurture sequence because I would write it and then I would read it out loud and go, that is absolutely not how I sound. That is not, I don't use these words. That's not how I talk. Write it as if you are writing to a friend. Only ever ask your subscribers to do one thing per email. Including too many call to actions is the quickest way to get them to do none of them. Now, I know that was a lot to take in. Sit tight because I'm going to give you something at the very end of this video that's going to basically take all that confusion away for you. Okay, we are at the point where I'm going to be showing you behind the scenes of my workflow. This is all going to come together in one gorgeous looking automated sequence. Before we dive into that, if you have been looking for an email marketing platform that doesn't make you want to eat your laptop out the window, I highly recommend Flodesk. It makes email marketing so freaking easy, and just look at it. It's so clean and aesthetic. If you want to try Flodesk, there is a link in my description that will get you a 30-day free trial. And if you sign up after the free trial, you get 50% off your first year, which is pretty cool. So there is three parts to setting this up. The first thing is creating a form for your subscribers to opt in to your freebie. I have a full page form here that will allow people to opt in to receive that freebie. The second thing is your initial workflow. So the only thing that's included in this workflow is when somebody subscribes to receive that opt-in. So when they're added to the segment for that opt-in, they will receive an email giving them that opt-in. So that's email number one, delivering the opt-in. Once they've received that email, they will have completed that workflow. And then I have a second workflow, which is the actual nurture sequence workflow. And you'll see here that the trigger is once someone opts into any one of my freebies, I've initially set a time delay. And the reason for that is once someone opts in, that day immediately they receive the first email, which is the opt-in freebie that they signed up for. And then a day later is when I want that second email to go out. So I don't want it to go out the same day because they're going to get two emails and that's going to be too much. So I've got a time delay of wait one day. And then I have that second email going out that's all about gratitude and expectations. And you'll also notice that I haven't added in any blocks or any of the fancy things that Flodesk allows you to do, all of their little layouts and blocks and things, because I like to keep it as if I was emailing a friend. Now coming back, we've got another time delay of one day because like I said, we want to send those emails out one day at a time to just give them time to read them, not overwhelm them. The third email here is where I'm diving deeper into my brand story, talking about my struggles. And like I said, this is quite a longer email and you want to make sure that you're breaking up those paragraphs into digestible sections so it doesn't look too overwhelming. You don't want any big chunks of text. And then the fourth and final email, again, we're waiting one day, is to give them that little gift. And I've included that as part of the subject line so they know that that's what they're going to be getting. I've even made note here that yes, I know the last email was quite in depth. I'll keep this one short. Here's your freebie. And then here is where I'm directing them to join my Discord community, or maybe they want to just follow me on Instagram. And I've also noted here, again, I like to use what's called the PS method. And each email has a little PS. So this says, PS, thanks again for supporting me and my content. If there is ever anything I can help with, don't hesitate to email me. My inbox is always open for you. Again, we're building that connection. Then once they've received that email, the subscriber will have completed the workflow and then they will just go on to receive my normal weekly emails. Now, because I love you guys so much and I know that email marketing is extremely overwhelming, I've actually put all of this into a nurture sequence, a newbie-friendly nurture sequence guide so that you can follow it step by step. I've included all of my tips and tricks, and I've also included copies of my own nurture sequence emails for you to use as reference so that you can go about creating your own nurture sequence and get that up and running. So if you want to get your hands on that, the link is in the description below. Also, the link for my Discord is below, so feel free to come and join me over there. That's it for this video. Thanks for sticking around. I hope you found it helpful, and I'll see you next time. Did my hair look like that the whole time?
Hi, what's up?
Hey.
Hey.
How you doing?
Nurture.
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 Nurture sequence.
Nurture sequence.
Newbie friendly nurture sequence.
Oh my God. Why did I call it that? That is such a tongue twister.